everyone, welcome to my channel. It's lovely to be here again to do yet another video. Anyway, my channel is about our home, our plants, hair, makeup, whatever, all the nice things. And I love to style. I love to try to style my home in a way that is fresh and clean, and don't we all? But if we were minimalistic more so, then everything would be great. But I like so many of you, you know, we have ornaments, and we have things that reminds us of certain experiences and times in our life, and we really don't just want to get rid of those things. So anyway, that's the sort of state that I'm in at the moment, trying to decide what can go and what can stay, and that sort of a thing. So I'll take you along with me as I go along. Anyway, today I was going to talk about one of my plants. This is my beautiful medallion. Of course, I have George here. I call him George. I will talk to you about George on another occasion. It's quite a lot to say about George. But today I wanted to talk about my beautiful medallion. She's just absolutely lovely. I haven't had her that long, as I was saying in my first video. I used to have plants, but that was a long time ago, and now I've just started to enjoy having plants again. And I think plants come to you a bit like pets. You know, you go through certain things in your life, certain experiences, and, you know, sometimes you go to buy a pet, and you can have all the litter and they're absolutely beautiful, every one of the pups or kittens or whatever, but one of them will come to you literally or pull you somehow or other. It's not just about, oh, you're a pretty little guy, I'm going to you. There's a feeling, and there's sometimes the pet itself actually comes towards you, and you know that's the one. And it's like that, I think, with with plants as well. I never realized that so much as recently, when I was going through a few things myself, and yeah, and they just called that to me. It was just so therapeutic and beautiful. And I thought, yeah, why not? You know, I love plants. I always love plants. I cannot keep away from the garden centres. I don't know how you ladies are, but or any of you out there actually. But I'm a bit green fingered, not too good at it, I've got to say. But I do, I have to have my plants. I have to have my plant pots in the garden and the patio and, you know, various areas in the garden. And I'm hoping that in the later spring and summer, when I start tidying up the garden a bit, that I can bring you with me to my various little areas in my garden that I've created and show you what I'm trying to achieve there. But for today, I'm talking about this lovely, beautiful medallion. She's absolutely lovely. They say that they call them the medallion because they have such beautiful, big, saucer-like shaped leaves that are patterned. They're not just plain. And they're actually shiny. And they've got these lovely patterns, and absolutely beautiful patterns, and different shades of green and almost like limey cream kind of color going around here in this lovely shape. It's absolutely beautiful. Now, I would have been very nervous about buying a big plant in the past because they are big and they take up room. But as I was saying, I'm trying to give my home a whole new look, and I'm really enjoying the plants at the moment. So I thought, well, why not get rid of some of the ornaments that are just being there for years, you know, gathering dust and everything. Why not just choose certain pieces and arrange the furniture in certain ways and, you know, give everything a fashion look. And whenever I go abroad, like Spain and places like that, and they have the lovely white walls and beautiful plants, and it's just such a nice, fresh look. So I've gone that way now. And I'm really enjoying it, actually. It's a bit of work, though, of course. But look at this beautiful, beautiful, almost like wine. I hope you can see. Maybe you see better with this one.
Can you see better with this one? Absolutely lovely. Now, if I stand back for 1 second, and I don't move, okay, I want you to look at the leaves. Focus on one leaf. Try that one. And you'll see it's moving. And it's moving because you probably already know these are prayer plants. And basically what that means is that they open their leaves down in the day to allow all the sun to go onto the leaves for the richness and goodness that they need from the light. But in the evening, they kind of protect themselves. I don't know why, but they lift up. And she is now in the process of starting to lift. And every now and again, I see one of her leaves going like this. And if you go away for a little while, a couple of hours, you'll find that she'll, when you come back, that she has actually lifted a leaf that bit further. I mean, this one is really quite erect at the moment, as you can see. Anyway, they come from a warm climate and they need the warmth. They don't like drafts. Now, at the moment, we're in spring, well, the very, very start of spring. So we're just starting to get a couple of warm, sunnier days. That's okay for her to be by the window. But when the summer comes or late spring and you get some strength in that sun, I may have to push her a little bit further away because they say that you can't let the sun get on the leaves too much, otherwise the leaves will burn. They love high humidity, hence the warm climates that they came from. And so therefore, misting is a good thing. And you can mist the leaves just lightly, and apparently that really does them some good. Or you can sit them on a tray of water and let the water rise. And if you were to go away for a while, it would be a good idea. You just move her away from the immediate brightness and put a saucer of water under her, give her a good soaking. And just leave her. She will be too wet to start with, but as she dries out, so the water on the tray will also be rising gently in the daytime and help to keep her going until you get home. Obviously, if you've got a friend or family member, then you don't have to worry, but if you were away for a weekend or a long weekend or a week, a plant this size will need regular water. Now, I'm having to water her every other day, and although we're in early spring, it's not exactly warm out there at all, especially here in England. But we have to have radiators or we have to have a fire on. And if we do, then the house gets very warm and then the air gets dry. So it's not good for her. And so she needs more water. And one of the ways she tells me she needs water, and it's wonderful actually, because a lot of plants don't tell you. I mean, there are quite a few plants that do tell you, but there's quite a few that don't, and until it's too late. But this one, she will tell you, these calpheas will tell you when they need water. They will just literally droop. And it's like fainting. And if you haven't had one of these, this is what they do, they faint. If you see that happening, it's not opening the leaves for light, it's fainting, it's far lower. And then you just got to grab the water as quick as you can. And they will react to the water very quickly. I mean, this morning she seemed as though she was fainting again. I thought, well, I only gave you some water. Was it yesterday or the day before? It was so in my mind, it was so close. But anyway, so that's the sort of thing they need. The bigger they get, the more water they get need. And another way to tell that they need water is if they literally do this. They literally curl up their leaves on the ends like that. Can you believe it? Now, feeling this leaf, the tension and strength just wants to be open. I mean, if I lift it right up, it won't stay there. Although I think I've just bent her a bit. But they can actually lift the edges of their leaves up like that. And when I first saw that, I thought, my God, what have I done? You know, have I given her too much fertilizer? Have I overwatered her? Oh my God, because I mean, she's so beautiful, I don't want anything to happen. But it turned out that it was just literally another sign that she needed water and that possibly the air is too dry or too hot. So, you know, they speak to you, these ones, and they're really quite lovely. And they're so beautiful. I've got her on. I'll try and show you in a minute. I've got her on like a little tabletop like that. A nice white pot, and she's in that. I'm just turning her around a bit. She's quite big, isn't she? She's quite lovely. I love her. And my pride and joy, one of my pride and joys anyway, I'm starting to enjoy the larger plants in my life. I always used to have small ones. Always going for the babies. Because, you know, well, you know yourself, you see one of these little tiny little loves and you think, oh my goodness, my goodness. Anyway, where the light is concerned, it's like most plants, medium to bright, but no direct sun on these, no direct sun at all. And just look at the size of that leaf compared to my hands or even my face. Look at that. Quite big, isn't it? They're non-toxic, which is great, plants for, you know, if you've got children, dogs and all that sort of thing. Water with these. Water is the most important because of this misting and of the fact that they dry fast. Whereas a lot of plants, you know, there's quite a few, I mean, I call him George here. He hardly needs a drink. I mean, he's so resilient and resourceful. He is forgiving. I'll come back to him another day. But she is not. And if she bends too much, then there becomes a little break in the stem. Well, it's more like a bend, you know, like a crease. You don't want that either because obviously the water flow and all the rest of it. So as the leaves get a bit loopy, bit dangly, I've got a little stick here for one of them. There, I put that one on a little stick, but I may have to put another one or two because I don't want those bends, I don't want anything happening to her. She's so lovely. So there is my assessment of the medallions. House plant feed is fine, but apparently you have to have a little iron, I read. So I think I'm going to, you know, look out for that. Most houseplant feeds do have a little iron, so just check it out because apparently they need it. Maybe it's this richness of the colour or something, I just don't know. Maybe that's the reason why they need that. But anyway, so, and as for the styling, I thought I would put her on this other side of my lovely console table here. Anyway, I'll say bye for now then, and hopefully I'll be doing another video very soon. I'm not sure what that will be about, hope you enjoy my other videos. Please like and subscribe and try and support me, because obviously I'm only just started, and tell your friends that you've seen a new video, and you know, maybe they'll come and have a look, see what I've been up to, what I've been doing, and see you all soon. Enjoy your plants.
Bye.